Hello everyone, today we're actually taking a look at some Android malware, but before we get to that, I want to give a quick shout out to my friend Siraj, who actually alerted me to this and let me know that it existed. Now I've been good friends with Siraj for many years, dating back to my freshman year of high school, so since 2005 I've known this guy, and we've been good friends since then. And now, he has this very in-depth, very informative YouTube channel dealing with computer science and machine learning, sort of advanced programming techniques to make a machine learn as you program it. So if that's something that you think would interest you, certainly interests me, I suggest you go check it out. You can follow the annotation on the screen or check out the link in the description. So Siraj suggested I take a look at this malware called Elite. Now this is actually for Android, and from an overview, it's relatively simplistic. I mean, my friend Rogamp has looked at some ransomware for Android. Now that's pretty cool, you know, locking yourself out of everything on your phone and demanding payment to get back into it. However, this goes the more sort of old school route. Right away, it starts sending SMS messages from your account until your balance is empty. It also blocks your access to SMS features and Messenger, and then wipes your SD card. You can see, I'm just reading from this list, but unfortunately on this virtual machine I'm using, I can't show you the Messenger parts, but I can show you it deleting files and then methods to try and remove it. Now this Trojan also attempts to employ deep learning in that it learns from the apps you're using on your phone and then attempts to either avoid detection or avoid basically being able to be removed by the user based on what you actually open. Before we do anything, this is our shared folder. This actually represents the SD card that would be inserted into your phone. Here I just have some pictures of some DDR scores, Dance Dance Revolution, that I've gotten over the past few months. You know, basic nerd stuff, but nothing too important. Now imagine you had a bunch of apps or files or pictures or whatever you might have on your SD card that you wouldn't want to lose. Well, you wouldn't want to download this Trojan. So now it's on the phone, we're going to go ahead and install it. And right away, it actually wipes our shared folder. All of our pictures are immediately gone. So that's bad. And right now, if we actually had access to Messenger and any messaging applications, we would be locked out of them and it would be sending random messages to our contacts to drain our balance. And finally, we get the prompt that says, to ensure the correct installation of Elite, you must press the activate button below, which gives it administrator privileges. So we're gonna go ahead and do that. Now, I must apologize. I am a complete Android noob. I actually use an iPhone, and I have since about 2009, so you can hate on me all you want for that. But I'm trying to sort of struggle through this so I can demonstrate what Elite actually does. First things first, we have it installed, but now it has disappeared from our apps list. And it does not appear on our recent apps either. So, you know, basic stealth kind of stuff is happening. If we take a look on our apps list, we can see it installed here. However, we cannot stop it, uninstall it, move it, do anything, and we can take a look at the things it can actually do with our phone or our tablet or what have you. So we can read the phone status and identify, edit text messages, read them, send SMS messages, read your contacts, modify or delete the contents of your SD card, which we've already seen it has done. So basically, as soon as you install this, your device loses all data from the SD card. We'll also retrieve running apps and start and run at startup, so we can see that it's viewing what you're trying to run. And so now we're going to try downloading an antivirus. We're going to use AVG actually, and usually it can detect it. However, you'll see in a moment something interesting happen with that sort of deep learning stuff that I was talking about. Okay, so we're launching AVG. I'm going to go ahead and get started. Give me the ads, we're gonna scan. We'll see if AVG will actually pick up on this. It's found a couple threats so far. Almost done with the scan. And there we go. Simple message receiver may contain potentially unwanted program. And then we also have malware detected as Elite. So this actually came out last year, so it only makes sense that it would now be detected and classified as malware. If we try to uninstall it, we can't because it's a device administrator, but luckily this prompt allows us to deactivate it and then uninstall it. And then uninstall. Where did AVG go? AVG. Okay, we're stuck here. That's nice. Okay, let's try relaunching AVG. Okay, take two. Alright, we have now successfully uninstalled this malware from our device. If we take a look in the apps, it is no longer present, and Elite is no longer on the phone. However, the damage has been done. Your SMS messages have been charged to your account, and your SD card contents have been lost. But now, let's take a look at one more thing that I actually found during preliminary testing of this Trojan. Okay, so this part is recorded a bit before the parts I recorded previously, but I wanted to document this because this was pretty interesting to me. So I was doing some preliminary testing on Elite, and so we saw before that AVG was able to detect it, and here we do have it still installed. It's right here, it's running, would be sending SMS messages. It's already deleted the contents of the SD card once again. It will run at startup, etc. But this time when we run AVG, it doesn't pick it up. So maybe this is an example of that sort of learning behavior, sort of learning how to avoid detection when before we've seen that it already was able to detect it. So here AVG says we are protected, even though we already know that Elite is fully installed and operating in the background as we speak. Of course, maybe that just goes to show that AVG is complete garbage. So we are going to try downloading another antivirus. We'll see if that makes any difference. Why not Norton? Because everybody knows Norton is good. Avast. Avast is better. We'll actually do a good one for once. Okay, so let's try this scan here with Avast. So Avast has actually detected it, so although it may have evaded AVG this time, it did not evade an actually good antivirus. So let's see, if we uninstall here, did it work? Did it uninstall? No. At least AVG let us, you know, fix the administration issues. Okay, so this is turning out to be a lot of fun. So yeah, Elite is still installed. I'm pretty sure. Yeah, so AVG didn't find it, and Avast found it, but can't delete it. So that's a lot of fun, isn't it? Alright, let's try Norton. Okay, so our device is at risk. Did it find? Yes, it found Elite. Can we delete it? Alright, Norton lets us manage the device administrator, so surprisingly, Norton actually did it. I'm amazed. That should take care of it. Okay, we are good to go now. So AVG stopped detecting it for some reason. Avast found it but couldn't remove it, and then Norton actually solved all our issues, so that's kind of scary. But I think that is about it. I don't have much more I can cover about this. Yeah, there's not much more I can say about Elite, but please be sure to check out my friend Siraj's YouTube channel if you're interested in learning how to combat these sorts of threats and learning the sort of advanced programming techniques. If you're interested in any kind of computer science, I recommend you go check it out. So you can follow the annotation on the screen or the link in the description. And yeah, that's about it. Thanks for watching.